I remember the story of Helen. She was 6 years of age, and she was playing the piano, and unbeknown to her parents, she overheard them say, "Oh, Helen is so clumsy, she'll never be able to play the piano well." So ever thereafter, whenever Helen played the piano, she played clumsily to prove to the world that what her parents said about her was true. When she grew up and she was 13 and 14, she always played clumsily to prove to the world that what her parents said were true. Not only that, when she used her fingers to sew and to cook, she was clumsy to prove to the world that what her parents said about her was true. I said to her, "My dear child, you can't be held responsible for the actions of other people, even if they be your parents. Your parents probably meant that you were clumsy at that time. You weren't thinking of your piano playing. They didn't think that you were clumsy forever." Yes. She got the message. So she removed that little scar within her, because a year later, she played better.
90% of the men and women alive today have an image of themselves as distorted as the reflection in a funhouse mirror. Since they see themselves as distorted and warped, they act that way. The first and basic truth of cybernetics, the one you must learn in order to unlock the door to a better life, is image is all. The full implications of this all-important truth started to take shape more than 30 years ago, as a young plastic surgeon began to sort through the photographs that were the record of his professional accomplishments. By giving his patients a new face, he often found he had given them a new self-image. It was no longer necessary for them to hate themselves and to believe everyone else hated them too. But always, there were a few puzzling exceptions. Girls made beautiful again, men saved from ugliness, with no change in their personality. It was then Dr. Maltz began to be fully aware of the implications of self-image. What you are and look like to the rest of the world means nothing. All that counts is what you look like to yourself. You are happy or unhappy, sick or well, successful or unsuccessful, only as your own self-image demands that you be. That plastic surgeon was Dr. Maltz. And it was then he began to be aware of the importance of the self-image. Today, Dr. Maltz is internationally famous. Millions have read about Dr. Maltz and his discovery, and still more have heard about him.
Why is self-image so important?
The self-image sets the boundaries of human accomplishment. It is the key to your personality, to your behavior, to your character. Enlarge the scope of your self-image through confidence, and you enlarge the scope of what you can do in this world to reach self-fulfillment. Most people have an idea that they are either born to succeed or born to fail, that they're happiness prone or unhappiness prone. That is not true. Many years ago, a beautiful young girl of 18, Anna by name, came to my office. She was in an auto accident. Her left cheek was disfigured. I gave her back her beauty. She looked into the mirror and said, "I don't see any difference." I showed her the pictures taken immediately after the accident, showing her scar. She looked at the pictures, then into the mirror, and finally said, "Well, I see a difference, but I don't feel any different." I probed into her background, into her past, and ascertained that 2 years before the accident, she was engaged to a young man who suddenly ran off and married someone else. That left her with hurt feelings, with feelings of depression, resentment, that she was nobody. In other words, she had an inner scar long before she had the scar on her face. I said to her, "My dear child, you can't be held responsible for the actions of someone else." She got the message. A year later, she married another man. It suddenly dawned on me then that as a plastic surgeon, it might be a wonderful idea if I could write a book for the 90% of the people all the world over who have normal faces but some inner emotional scar, write a book for them to show them how they could be their own plastic surgeon and remove the scar within them that they put there, remove it like Anna did. And so I wrote the book, Psycho-Cybernetics.
What does psycho-cybernetics mean?
Well, cybernetics comes from the Greek word, which means a helmsman, a man who steers a ship to port. And psycho-cybernetics means steering your mind to a productive, useful goal so that you too can reach port. And what is your port? Peace of mind.